Tactical just got back from searching Zhang's home.
Anything promising?
It's hard to say. All the documents we've got
Watch this.
Are in Chinese.
We've got his hard drives, scans of everything in the safe. There was something compromising in Zhang's
house. That's not a hard drive.
We got it.
We're heading down to forensics.
That was a power
now
supply.
We'll organize everything we pulled.
Give me a break. What a joke.
We'll have plenty of stuff to go through in the morning.
Oh! Well, we all know that wasn't a hard drive, but we are going to be talking about hard drives right here on this episode of RuneStone Gaming's Tips and Tricks Hard Drives. Stay tuned. Yo, what's up, my Viking crew? Welcome to the Longhouse. I'm RuneStone Gaming, and in this episode, we're going to be talking all about hard drives. First question we got to ask ourselves is, what is a hard drive? Hard drives are obtained from crash sites. Find crash sites in and around the map in unique locations. After finding a crash site, the crash site will require certain things, sometimes power, resources, things like that. You'll put the resources or you'll connect the power to the crash site and you'll be able to grab the hard drive. You'll take the hard drive, you'll drop it into the map, and you'll have access to three alternative recipes after a 10-minute time of wait. These alternative recipes, they're super cool. Really important part of the game. You're gonna have to do this. However, I'm not gonna talk about those alternative recipes today. I'm just gonna talk about best practices about how to go out and find them. In order to find the greatest level of success while finding these hard drives, you're gonna wanna do a few things first. First, find your nearest quartz node, drop a miner and a few constructors next to it. We're gonna be making some stuff with the quartz. You're also going to want to unlock the MAM. This is after tier one. It's a super basic thing to unlock, but that's what you're going to want. It's called the MAM, the MAM. So head over to the quartz, drop the quartz miner, drop a couple constructors, and we're going to start mining some of that quartz. And we're going to turn it into quartz crystal. Open up the MAM, go to the quartz side inside of the MAM. And you're gonna wanna finish this tree all the way down to frequency mapping. This will give you your map. You're also gonna wanna work on the alien organism side of the MAM as well. There's a few upgrades that you're going to need to help expand some of your inventory so when you eventually do go out and you start searching, you're gonna have plenty of space. What you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna go out and fight a little bit just in the surrounding area. You're gonna need some carapace and you're gonna need some alien organs. Now, both the carapace and the organs are gonna allow you to upgrade the MAM. You're gonna wanna upgrade the MAM to where you get down to the inventory bonuses. Expanded tool belt will give you one extra hand slot, which you can use to eat yum, yum, yum nuts.
Eat my nuts, 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 eat my nuts.
And the inflated pocket dimension will give you 5 more slots of inventory. Extremely crucial to search for these juicy hard drives. You're also gonna need some blade runners. Blade runners are this really cool equipment that you put on your body that increases your movement speed by 50%. It also lowers some of your fall damage and allows you to jump pretty high. I highly suggest you pick these up along the way. Find the nearest Caterium node, mine some Caterium. You'll unlock Caterium in the MAM. Go to the MAM, drop the Caterium in, and continue down the tree until you get to blade runners. It's gonna be a couple down. You're gonna need maybe a constructor and some Caterium to make some quick wire, but you'll unlock quick wire and then you'll unlock the blade runners. Find some modular frames that are in and around some of the crash site locations that might be near you. Grab those modular frames, make those blade runners because you're gonna really need those to be successful. You're also gonna wanna find some slugs around your map so you can unlock the power slug tier under your MAM as well. Find a green slug in and around your base, go up to your MAM, drop your slug in and unlock power shards. You'll then want to unlock overclocking. This will be used when you're using biogenerators. We're going to overclock them a little bit. So find your green slug, turn it into the MAM, unlock overclock, and that's one more step to being successful. Another incredibly important thing that you're going to need is double ramps. Double ramps are unlocked in the Awesome Shop. The Awesome Shop becomes available in Tier 2, super easy to get. I know that you guys can do that. Get to the Awesome Shop. Go to where your quartz is, drop a sink, sink some of your quartz into the sink, get about 3 tickets, go to the Awesome Shop and buy double ramps. It's the very first thing that you should do in this game is sink crystals till you get enough tickets to buy those double ramps. Double ramps are gonna save you a ton of concrete while you're exploring. It's gonna be able to move you a whole lot quicker around the map. I highly, highly suggest you get double ramps from the Awesome Shop. It's just three tickets. So now you've got your prerequisites to going out and exploring. You've dropped your MAM, you've gotten your frequency mapping from the court side of the MAM tree, you have finished alien organisms and got the extra hand slot, you've got the extra five inventory slots, you've unlocked Blade Runners and you've built Blade Runners, you have unlocked power shards and you have a couple on you for the bio generators, and you've unlocked double ramp via the Awesome Shop. Well, now we're ready for some quick hits. Don't bother going back to your base. Drop the MAM wherever you're at, put the hard drive in, recycle the MAM, you'll get all your resources back. Keep doing that. That's gonna make it, if you die or something happens, you're gonna be A-okay because your hard drives are gonna constantly be going. Here's a little game. Drop a hard drive in and try to find the next one before the next hard drive is done. Bring beacons. Beacons will prove invaluable to you in your progress. Sometimes you might get to a crash site that you're not necessarily prepared for. Drop a beacon, put a little reminder. I like to make mine red. And then I like to say like, oh, this is the resources it needs, this is the power that it needs, and I can always come back to it. Most likely what's gonna happen is you're gonna go down to the next crash site location, and you're gonna find the thing that you needed, and then you're gonna come right back to where you were. But because you dropped the beacon, you're totally gonna remember what you exactly needed. Bring a stack of a lot of resources. You've got the inventory space now, feel free to bring some stuff. Bring a stack of modular frames, a stack of rotors, a stack of screws, a stack of reinforced iron plate, two stacks of plates, two stacks of rods. Use the rods and the plates to build observation towers. Observation towers do two things. The first thing they do is they mark hard drive locations that you've already obtained. They also allow you to get up high, move up high, and see things from a far away distance. Press P on your keyboard, mouse wheel in, and you can easily see where you need to get to next. Don't be scared, guys. The wilds on this planet, they're pretty intense sometimes, but keep pushing forward. I know you can do it. Make sure your health is topped off at all times. Collect all the berries, collect all the bacons, and make sure you eat your nuts.
Eat my nuts, 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 eat my nuts.
See a spitty boy? Build a wall. See a chargey boy? Build a ramp. Build a wall. Make it so they can't get to you. The best thing that you can do is not fight them if you don't need to. If you see a crash site, never walk directly up to it. Lay ramp foundation up to the crash site and a flat foundation on top of it. Then you can easily lean over to the side and access the hard drive without encountering all the various dangerous wildlife. Use slide jump. You do this by holding shift. You should be constantly be running anyways. Then hit C, you'll begin to slide, and hit spacebar. You'll know that you'll be doing it right is if you slide, you'll accelerate. Now sometimes it doesn't work, and it definitely won't work going downhill or uphill. Be super careful when you're jump sliding, because you just might not end up where you want to end up in.
But that Yahoo article told me to get it! Oh no! Holy f***! Holy f***! No, 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 no! Woo!
Woo! I hope you guys all enjoyed my hard drive tips and tricks. And if you have any questions or comments or concerns, make sure you guys ask me down there in the comments. Like and subscribe if I taught you anything in this video. And I'll see you guys on the stream. Thank you guys so much. See you on the next episode, right here in the Longhouse.
I asked for a car, I got a computer. How's that for being born under a bad sign?